At Flawless Events, what we do is, say for instance, you're a company and you want to organize a conference where you want to talk about, let's say, medical issues. So it will be called, I'll go sit with a client and they'll say, we want to call 500 of the top doctors in the city. We don't know where we want to have it, but we want to be able to talk about the current solutions we have for different diseases. I don't know. And so we'll sit there and talk to the client and not focus about the event, but more about what do you want to get out of the event at the end of it? So we focus on that. Like what would success look like for you as a client? Okay, we focus on that with them. And then we'll go back to the office, scream my head off by the fact that somebody actually trusted me with this project, honestly, because we take, to this day, by the way, I'll take a project as a schoolwork. Like I said, I'm very disciplined at getting things done. The morning before an event, I'll have a stomachache and be like, oh my God, this is actually happening. The event is about to come alive. But I digress. So we then go and say, okay, it's 500 people. Where should this take place? So we start looking at the different venues in the city. And through the conversation, we would have known the kind of budget that the client has. So like, well, we can't have it in this venue, it would be too expensive for them, but we could possibly have it in this venue. And then they would have talked about, you know, the kind of things that they want the conference to have. So we'll focus on what should the stage look like? Should we have a lot of screens, or they don't have a budget for it? So should we just do a banner printing? They need to get magazines produced. So we'll have a designer to sit down and, you know, work out the content, and then we'll get that printed. They have delegates coming in from abroad. So we'll process their visas to be able to come through the airport, and we'll pick them up from the airport and take them to the different hotels. We'll print the badges for everybody to have their badges on. And then if there's a specific color that the logo of the company has, for instance, we'll bring it in through the banners that are printed, the branding, or it could be through the chair colors. It could be in different, you know, subtle messaging. We go with the video and production companies to make sure that the sound is there. If the hotel system is not good, we'll bring something else in. But as we do all these different steps, we constantly communicate with the client. We let them know how things are going. Are people registering? If they're not, should we advertise the event? Maybe that will pull people more in to participate. Should we distribute all these invitation cards to every hospital? In which case, now we're printing invitation cards. We're hiring more bike kits to go around and distribute these invitations. So we are the house that all the logistical details happens. The client will talk about the content. What are they going to talk about? We can't touch that. That we leave to them. But everything else that is required for any delegate to walk in a room, be comfortable, have their food in a, you know, in a sanitary way, to be able to listen and watch. When you're in a conference room, you think, oh, this is easy. This is natural. Of course it happens. But it doesn't. Somebody else had to make sure that every little thing was tested, works, and makes sense before anybody walks into that room. So we're that office that constantly works to make sure that whatever the client wanted is not just done, but it also is done in a way that exceeds their expectation. So we're this constant, like almost bees that just like buzzing all through the day and all through the night, especially as we get close to an event. That's when we're working 24/7 to produce an event. And so because what we do in an honest, genuine, and with so much passion, we've grown from doing one event a year, honestly. And I was okay with just doing one event a year. Then it was about three events a year. Now we do like 60 to 70 events a year. It's insane. Even I don't know how we do it anymore. But I bring in girls, and I usually focus on girls because we have attention to detail. We don't give up. We are persistent, and nothing is too small of a job to be done, whether it's making copies, whether it's getting coffee, whether it's going, you know, running out and distributing things because they're running late, whatever it is, we just get it done, right? So I bring in girls who have passion to just do events. They don't even have to have experience doing events, but if they have the passion for it, and you can tell when somebody's talking about that industry, if they're going to make it, because it's exhausting. If you don't love it, you cannot survive in it. And I tell them how I would like things to be done, but then I leave the rest for their creativity and for them to take it to what they feel is a flawless standard. So now as a company owner, what I'm working on is, it shouldn't be my Yoadan standard. we're working towards establishing what is a flawless standard so that anybody who works at that company can then just rise to that, to the brand name, right? So with that, and with the, because of the attention of detail that we put into it, we've been able to work with companies like Microsoft, IBM, Coca-Cola, Heineken, the US Embassy, international organizations who come like John Hopkins, the Gates Foundation, and many more. Like, I blank out as I speak about it, but if you look at our website, which is www.flawlessevents.net, you'll see the range of clients we've been able to work with. And sometimes I don't usually look at the website once it's updated and I go look at it. I'm in awe of what we've been able to do and go, oh my God, all these clients actually trusted us. And it's, that's what it is, right? Because people are actually putting their entire project in our hands and trust that we will do it. And something as small as somebody not being able to enter the country or not being picked up from the airport can completely ruin the mood of the event. So to say, okay, we trust you, you'll get it done. And we actually do get it done. We don't just talk about it and not do it. It's, I don't know, it's a high that keeps me going. And to this day, it's just, yeah, we love doing what we do.